Hello all, welcome back to the session, the final session. This is going to be a lab activity and we are going to try out another active learning strategy which is known as team pair solo. So in this, how it has to be done is, the first activity will has to be done as a full team. So here by team, I am implying that all RC. I am considering one RC as one team, okay. So there is a group activity for the RC, then within the RC the next phase is, once the team phase's activity is completed, the next phase is the pair phase. In the pair phase within the RC, in groups of two, you will have to do some activity that you had done in team phase. Then finally in the solo phase, as individuals, you have to complete one more activity which is again connected to the previous two activities. So I'll just go to the slides for this session. Essentially, I'll just explain what the team, pair and solo activities are. So in the morning, all of you had asked a lot of questions regarding both the technologies, different technologies, and we had used a mechanism of transferring the floor and getting answers from other participants. So over here, what we are going to do is do the team pair activity based on the same principle, that you collect the questions at your remote center and get answers from other participants as well. So for collaboration at remote center, so in the team phase, which should take roughly around 20 minutes, as a remote center, you have to create a WordPress page for yourself. So the remote center coordinator create a WordPress page for yourself. The web page should have the following menu tabs: home, participants, questions asked and answers provided. In the home page, provide the description of the RC. Now, in the participants page, list the name of participants and link their individual WordPress pages that they created using FDP 101X. Finally, in the questions asked page, consolidate all the queries from the remote center regarding the use of Moodle, Screencast, WordPress, and AView. So, we had familiarized you with four technologies in the previous FDP. So just like how you came up with different questions related to these four technologies, so within the remote center as a team, all these queries have to be elicited and it has to be listed, and this should come in the questions asked page. For doing the final two activities, it is important that the remote center coordinator coordinates with all the participants. So in this process, you will ensure that if there are repeat queries, then removing those repeat queries, etc., has to be done by the remote center coordinator. From the participant side, please ensure that all the valid queries that you have which are remaining unsolved, please put them right now. So all the queries that you have, you can put them in the list. Supposing there are some queries which get answered within the RC itself, remove them within the questions asked page. After creating the page, we will use a new technology to share the WordPress web pages. So this technology is called Padlet. So it will appear as a, you will see a blue window like this when you click this particular link. So the instructions on posting in Padlet is provided over there. So first you will have to click on this particular blue tab, then a white note will come. In that white note, then there is an option called post the title. In the title, give your RC ID and the name of the institution. So for example, here the title is instruction on posting in Padlet. So when you click on it, you will see the title page. And you can provide the RC ID and then the name of the institution. in the text, provide URL of the WordPress page that you created. So let me just show you how to do it. So I am going to type padlet.com/txfdp201x_lab1. So this is what you see when you open the Padlet website. Now on clicking it, you will see a note like this. So in the title, give that RC ID and then the name of the institution. So for example, I am from IIT Bombay, so I am just giving the RC ID as RC1000 and then giving the name of the institution. So our WordPress, then in the text, so this is the text where you have to type the WordPress URL. So for example, this is so I am giving a WordPress ID of our, so this is the page that we created for the previous faculty development program. So like that, you as a remote center, you have to create your own page. So you can see that some people have already started commenting on it. So I would ask all the participants just to wait for some time so that I can continue the instruction. So now that you have posted the URL, you have to ensure that you follow the same structure: home, participants, questions asked, answers provided. And you should ensure that in the questions asked page, all the questions gets listed. Once you have done that, in pairs, go and visit 3 unique RC pages. So we have around 160 RCs connected to us. So within an RC, now you can split the work into pairs. You will see the RC's web page in the Padlet. So as pairs, go to 3 unique RCs. Within a entire RC, you can split the work. So let's say pair 1 goes to the first 3 RCs, pair 2 goes to RC 4, 5, 6, pair 3 goes to RC 6, 7, 8, etc. Now as a pair, go to these 3 unique RCs and check their web page. If the web page does not have the structure as earlier, you can say that and there are no questions listed, then you can use the comment feature that you saw earlier. So you just have to go and click on the post, and below you can see add a comment. Over here you can see add a comment. Just below the post you can see something known as add as comment. So over there you can inform that no questions has been asked and wait for response from the RC. If the RC have a list of questions, then together try to find solutions to the questions asked by RC 1. So you have selected 3 RCs as a pair. So take the first RC and together find the answers to the questions asked by first RC. Convey your solutions to the RC's query again as a comment in their Padlet post. So again, you will have to use the comment feature and provide the answers that you are familiar with or that you know to the RC which you have selected. Now this will approximately take another 20 minutes, and in the final 20 minutes you had 3 RCs. Now out of these 3 RCs, you selected 1 RC and answered their queries. Now as an individual, take the remaining RC. So it could be either RC 2 or RC 3. So look at questions asked by the RCs from their page. Again, repeat the same process. In RC 2, look at the questions asked and try to answer it individually. So in the first, again I am repeating, in the team phase, create a WordPress page for the entire RC, list all the participants, create a page called questions asked. In the questions asked, populate all your queries about Moodle, Screencast, WordPress, and AView. Then, after creation of page, go to this Padlet. In that Padlet, post the URL of your WordPress page. After that, as a pair, take any three RCs and then try to solve the first RC's queries together. After solving the first RC's queries together, move to solo phase where you select the remaining two individually and solve their queries as well. The remote center coordinator during the pair phase and solo phase should consolidate all the answers that the participants are providing to different RCs. And the remote center coordinator should list them in the answers provided page. So for which RC, what answers were provided, all these things will come in the answers provided page. Now, for participants who have not been able to understand the instructions, what I have done now is I have uploaded the slide in the Padlet. So if you actually look at that RC 1000 IIT Bombay, then you can see that the session slides are available there and you can download them in your local. So I'll just repeat the instructions once again. As a team, take 20 minutes to create a WordPress page for the remote center. The WordPress page should have the following tabs: home, participants, questions asked, and answers provided. In the home page, provide description of the RC. In the participants page, list the name of participants and link their individual pages. In questions asked page, consolidate all the queries from the remote center regarding use of Moodle, Screencast, WordPress, and AView. So after creation of the page, go to this Padlet website and post your RC URL. Then in pairs, go to the same Padlet site and identify three unique RCs. Let's say RC1, RC2, and RC3. Look at the questions asked by the RCs from their page. Together, try to find solutions to the questions asked by RC1 and convey your solutions to the RC's query as comment in their Padlet post. In the solo phase, you will have to then individually try to answer the RC's queries. The RCC meanwhile can consolidate all the answers that are provided and list them in the answers provided page. So you can download this and better understand the instructions. What I'll do at this moment is I'll just take so if participants have query, I'm just going to two or three remote centers where I'll just interact with them to gauge whether they understood the instruction. So I hope the RCs will start doing the team pair solo activities now and will be posting the WordPress web pages in the Padlet. Now to RC1290, CDAC Noida. Have you understood the instructions for lab activity?
Yes.
Is there any queries that you have?
In the solo.
Huh.
So you have asked us to take three RCs. Let us say me and my friend, we are having three RCs.
Okay.
My friend and myself will do RC1 and RC2, let us say, will be done by me. RC3 is done by my friend.
Yes. So the question was how the RC1, RC2, RC3 is done. So RC1 will be done by the pair together. Then RC2 will be done by one of the pair and RC3 will be done by the remaining person in the pair. So let's say two persons, A and B, are the pairs. So A takes on, A and B together does RC1. Then A does RC2 individually, B does RC3 individually.
In the end, our RC coordinator has to upload out which RC was done by which person, right?
Yes, and all the answers also. In the answers posted page, So whatever answers you are providing, you should provide it to the RC coordinator so that he can post it in the answers provided page.
Okay. Okay, sir.
Yeah. So let me now go to the next RC 1136 PSG Coimbatore.
Could you please explain how to work on that Padlet?
So all you have to do is just type the web page and just click on that blue screen. That's it.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So you should ensure that as a RC, you create only single post and do not flood the Padlet with individual posts. So it is a single RC's web page that should come in the Padlet.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So this is RC 1026, St. Xavier's College, Kanyakumari.
The thing is, when the people work for answers, what to solve for it.
Yes.
So the answers will be also available, supposed to provide something more than that is there, or are we not supposed to look into the answers first?
So the question was, will the answers be posted initially? No. So the answers will be consolidated and provided towards the end. The remote center coordinator. So the first, all the questions have to be listed. So only if the questions are available, you can populate the answers, right? So if there are these unsolved queries within RC regarding any of the tool usage, that queries have to be posted in your WordPress web page, remote center's WordPress web page. Is it clear?
Okay, the unsolved queries related to casting, Moodle and all those.
Yes. So you can use that, and then once the participants start providing answers, the remote center coordinator can consolidate all these answers and populate the answers provided page.
Okay, sir.
Okay, I'll now go to RC 1032, Mufakkam Jah College of Engineering, Hyderabad.
Sir, how will we get this RC's URL, sir, to review it?
They will be all be posting in the Padlet page. So you as an RC, once you have created your page, that has to be posted in the Padlet. So just click on the Padlet, give your RC ID and institute name, and below that, give the URL of the WordPress page that you created as an RC.
Okay. So that will be RC1, but the other RC 2 and 3, in the Padlet only we'll find the WordPress URLs?
Yes. So all the, so just like how you are posting it, so the Padlet is a, what do you say, an interactive and collaborative whiteboard. So just like how you have a normal board, if you have, let's say, five students write something on the board, it is together, it is visible to everyone, right? So similarly, this is a virtual board that is available in the internet.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Okay.
We'll be doing our activities. Okay. Thank you, sir.
So next to RC 1100, MES Pillai Institute of Information Technology, Panvel. Have you understood the activities?
Yes, sir. We have understood the activity, but there is one confusion.
Yeah.
That page has to be created by workshop coordinator and not by remote center coordinator.
Yeah. So, for me, it is actually a coordinator at the remote center. So what I mean by the terminology is not the exact definition of remote center coordinator. So whoever is coordinating the workshop at the remote center, he is a remote center coordinator for me. Very sorry to all RCs. I am using a terminology, I'm not using the standard terminology. So if it is the workshop coordinator, yes, the workshop coordinator has to create that WordPress web page.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
You have understood the instructions also, right?
Only query. Yes, sir. We have understood the instructions and we have started creating the page.
Okay, great. So what I would suggest is, at this point, as a group, you should collect all the queries now. So I am expecting a lot more activities by the participants, where they provide you with all your their web pages and also the queries that they have.
After the discussion, we need to go to labs, right?
Yes, yes, yes. You can go to the labs.
Okay. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So let me now move to 1192, MGM's College of Engineering, Nanded, Maharashtra.
Sir, we are having some confusion about the solo interaction.
You understood the team face activity?
Yes.
So as a team, as an entire RC, you have to create a WordPress web page with all those things, and together you have to populate the questions asked. Okay. Now,
yes.
Once you create this WordPress web page, go to the Padlet and post your RC over there. So, just like how you are posting, all other RCs will also be posting over there. So, in the pair phase, as group, so you have around roughly 20-30 participants, right?
Yes.
Let us assume that there are 20 participants in your RC. So, there will be 10 pairs within your RC. So, each pair now has to go and look into the Padlet page and take 3 unique RCs. Once you take the 3 unique RCs, then go and look at the questions asked by one of them. So, let's say you have selected RC 1001, 1002, 1003. Now, together, go and look at RC 1001's query and find solutions to those and post it back to them as a comment. Now, repeat the same activity as individuals for the other two RCs. So, one of you would select RC 1002, the other member of the pair will select RC 1003.
And sir, that Padlet link is not workable, sir. Right now we have opened that.
Can you tell me why is it not workable? It's just, all you have to do is just click on it. Are you not able to get the Padlet link?
Yeah, yeah. Whatever, we have I tried just now, but it is not.
Okay, what I'll do is I'll share the URL in the chat. So you can take the URL from
okay,
the
sir.
Chat and check again.
Fine, fine. What the time limit to do this all things?
So ideally, at least, so each activity, it takes around 20 minutes. So at least the pair phase should get finished by today.
Pairing phase. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So I have posted the URL of the Padlet in the chat. Let me now go to RC1063, DY Patil, Pimpri.
Sir, this is a question regarding, as you said, the WordPress page of the remote center.
Yes.
It is to be prepared by the workshop coordinator.
Yes.
The first tab which you proposed is the home, might be something related to the remote center.
Correct.
The second tab is the participants, wherein we get list of participants.
Yes.
In that, what is expected is, we should have some information about the participant, might be their WordPress page or something else. As you said, the individual page of each of the participant.
Yes. If you have the name of the participant, just hyperlink the individual WordPress pages that they created during FDP 101.
Yeah. So my question here lies is, is it expected by the workshop coordinator to create this hyperlink, or since it is a teamwork of the RC itself, each of the participant can go and link for its own name? What is exactly expected?
I mean, it is up to the team. The workshop coordinator is creating the pages. So, see, in the team activity, the first and foremost thing is you will do division of the work. So, in the first instance, somebody will create all the WordPress page creation will be done by the workshop coordinator. In the meanwhile, maybe some other group can consolidate all these web pages and prepare a Word document with all the hyperlinks as a team, and then provide it to the workshop coordinator, who has the edit access of the WordPress page, and they will upload these texts, copy the text from Word page or Word page, and put it in the WordPress. So it is like the breaking, what do you say, task division has to be done at the RC, and you can do, I mean, as your team is comfortable with.
In our case, the number of participants are 90. So it's a bulk of work. And I think 90 gathering all the links together in a page and then editing and uploading it, giving the hyperlink, surely is time consuming.
No,
it will not happen in 20 minutes, sir.
So let me give an alternate. So suppose the workshop coordinator is creating the page right now. Okay. In the meanwhile, some other team member opens a Google Docs where every participant is given an access, and they all write their name and hyperlink their WordPress web page. So by the time the WordPress page of the remote center is created, the workshop coordinator has a list of 90 participants in a Google Doc. Okay, all the workshop coordinator has to do is just copy paste these 90 and put it in the WordPress web page.
Okay. Yeah. And one more question, sir. The next tab is about the questions.
Huh.
So we'll have to get everything and put it. Means all 90 participants, whosoever has the raised the queries, or they must have not raised, but whatever they are having, it is to be put together in that tab.
Yes. It has to be
the
put
last
together.
One is about the answers.
So,
yes, sir. This is fine. I'm pretty clear with this. But the last one about the answers.
Yes.
So if each participant is going to do 3 into 90, so it will take time. That is the only concern, that it will be a time consuming thing which will not be end by the end of the day.
Yeah, so I completely understand. So the issue is that may not all the phases may not happen. So at least try to complete till team pair. So the 90 participants, there will be 45 pairs. So just like earlier, if you have a shared Google document where everyone is posting the answers that they have provided, so getting 45 answers from the pair will not be too much of a time taking task, and hopefully it could be done by end of the session today. Am I right?
Okay. Surely we'll try our level best, but that was my first query, whether the time will be feasible or not. That is
okay.
What I'm so, just pondering.
So a general instruction to all participants, try to do at least till the pair phase, at least answering the queries till the pair phase and posting it in the Padlet post. When you come tomorrow, you will have a second lab session where you can then consolidate all the answers and then put it in the answers posted page. So this could be done across, let's say, in the coming few days. All of you have done pair work and individual work. So these works can be put in the web page in the subsequent days, maybe across a week.
Okay. And last thing before I quit, sir, that means somewhere it is mandated that the workshop coordinator should know WordPress, how to build, create WordPress. Fortunately, I know that because I was a part of the initial workshop.
Yeah.
But might be this could be a query with few workshop coordinators, that they themselves must not be knowing how to create this WordPress.
But
supposing
the workshop coordinator has a query, you have a lot of participants who are skilled enough to create a WordPress web page. So do not worry about that. So it is a teamwork. Okay. It is only a
teamwork.
Work. Okay. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Let me now go to RC1229.
My question is, you are mentioning about the Padlet, which has already been made by you.
Yes.
Is it okay? In that, is there a specific slot where we have to post our link?
No. So all you have to do is just click it. So as soon as you click it, it will go on top. So it is a sequentially. It gets posted sequentially.
Okay, that will be done automatically, or anywhere
yes.
we can click and do it.
Yeah. So whenever you click, it will.
So
it is in a streaming mode. So what happens is when somebody writes one post, then the next post will go on top of the post that has already been written.
Okay.
So there
is no specific slot.
Yeah, there is no specific slot. You can just continue posting.
Because there in the Padlet there is an option where you can have a specific slot.
Yes, it is the
in that slot we can number that.
Correct. So it is the grid or the grid option where you specify which grid it should go to. I have not used that over here because everyone is getting familiarized. I've been exposed to a new technology, and we'll take it in a slow way.
No. See, initially only if you can change the mode. Now also you can change it.
Yes.
It will come one by one. Blocks will come one by one, and each can be numbered. Later we can even sequentially arrange it.
Yes. So the challenge is that now everyone. So many of them might be seeing Padlet for the first time, and for them this is going to be a shock. I mean, where should I place it? So then I thought it is easier.
Okay.
The sequence comes automatically. Let the system decide the sequence, and later then I'll expose them to the grid and the other types of options in Padlet.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Second question is, you mentioned something about RC1000 IIT Bombay.
Yeah, that's a dummy
what
entry.
What is that?
That is a dummy entry. That is how to write RCID and institution name.
Okay. You're right. So what I understand is the instructions are, first of all, create a website in the name of the RC.
Yes.
In that there will be four
four tabs.
Yes.
RC name, participants, questions asked, and answers.
Yes.
Now questions asked will be filled up by us.
Yes. Correct.
And the answers will be filled up by the whoever is doing the entry. From other remote centers, answers will be filled up by somebody.
No, so the answers posted is not from other remote centers. So within your remote center itself, you have to consolidate all the answers that your participants gave to other RCs.
Okay. So then when we are doing it second time in the Padlet, which questions are we answering?
Okay. So I understand the confusion. So the idea is that together you collect all the questions that have been asked by other RCs and then try to answer most of the queries. Answers for the queries
will be already there on their website.
So answers are not coming in the website at this point. The answers, they have only the questions now. In the first phase, they are collecting all the questions. So suppose, let's say RC 1229, they have, let's say, 5 participants. 5 participants have 15 queries. So these 15 queries will be first posted in the questions tab. Now these 5 participants will go to the Padlet and identify different RCs. So let's say the
and answer
the questions that has been posted by the RCs in their own questions posted page.
So answers will be given in their answers page.
No. So when you create a WordPress page, only you, the RC coordinator or the workshop coordinator will have the edit permission. So others won't be able to write in their WordPress web page, right?
Yeah.
So you are using the WordPress web page as a mechanism to display all the queries that you have for which you need some resolutions. Participants from other RC will come and see this particular questions and provide their answers as a comment in your URL.
Okay.
And so what you have to do is, so your participants will also be providing comments in the URL, in the respective RC's URL. So you will have to consolidate all these comments that has been provided from the participants in the RC and then populate the answers posted page.
Okay. Yes, sir. Understood. Okay. Thank you.
Great. So I'm hoping that it has not been too much of a complex task. I'll be explaining about the benefits of team pair solo tomorrow. Why team pair solo, how it is used, when it has to be used, etc. RC 1148, Krishna Institute of Engineering, Ghaziabad.
Sir, our problem is that we couldn't get the solo activity, what we have to do, how to be done.
Okay. So you understood the team activity?
Yeah, that part is clear.
Pair activity, pair face activity
also done.
So you have selected 3 RCs, right? But together as a pair, you will do only for 1 RC.
Okay.
And in the solo phase, you will have to take the remaining 2 RCs individually and answer the queries.
Okay.
So what you did in
the pair
phase,
we have to select 1. And in the individual activity, the other 2.
Exactly.
Okay, so thank you.
Yeah. Let me now go to Bits Mesra 1331.
Our question is that, can you show a sample of creating page? How can we create step by step all the steps in team, in solo, and pairing work?
So you don't have to do separate pages in team, pair, and solo. So in FDP 101, you have created WordPress web page for yourself, right?
Created.
Yeah. So there are 4 menu pages about blog, etc., right? Instead of those 4 standard pages, rename the pages like home, questions asked, etc. And if you want to create a new page, go to the menu, go to WP admin, your WordPress page.
We have done that. We have created the 4 menus, all that participant ask questions and creating the links of participants. We have done that.
Okay.
And then we have to add URL.
Yes. So take the WordPress web page that you have. So make sure that it is that, so let's say you have created bitsmesra.wordpress.com. Just take that URL and go to Padlet, post it over there. Just click there, type your RC ID and so Padlet is just nothing but it's a common notice board, a collaborative notice board. So how you post in a let's say bulletin board in your own institution, similarly over here you can use technology to do it. That's all. So just click on that page, click on anywhere within that page, and then you can post your institution ID and the URL inside that. So let me see.
And in that pairing one in pairs, go and visit three unique RC pages.
Yes.
In that where we will do that pairing thing.
Okay. In the pairing has to be done inside the RC. So what you have is a big, so within the web page, all the RCs have posted their URLs. Now within your institution, yes. So let's say there are 4, 6, 8. So 8 people. You will have 4 pairs.
Okay.
Okay. So.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
You understood what it is, right?
An RC page we will get, na?
Huh. So all the other RCs will be posting their RC pages in the Padlet.
In the Padlet, we will get that RC.
Exactly. Okay. Exactly. And then as a pair, go and visit unique RCs and try to identify solutions for the questions posted by them.
We have to select RC 1, RC 2, RC 3, at least 3 RC.
Yes.
Okay. So, and I then mean, we have to answer one of the RC.
Yes. So as a pair, answer one of the RC. Then as individuals, answer the remaining RC's questions.
Okay. Okay.
And
thank
you, RC number 1, 2, 3 is just for example. I said RC 1, RC 2, RC 3. Other RCs will be posting their own RC IDs. Okay. Like you will be posting RC 1331.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Let me take 1209 KIIT College, Gurgaon.
Sir, from your presentation, we understood that this activity is to be decided and designed by center coordinator.
Yes.
Further actions will be taken by the participants, right?
Yes. Yes.
Sir, problem is that we, at present, we center coordinator is not here.
Okay. So,
can we do it ourselves?
Yes, yes. No. So, I mean, whoever is the responsible coordinator, so if you have, so as a team, since all RCs will have a workshop coordinator or a remote center coordinator. So, for this workshop, the remote center coordinator and workshop coordinator is one and the same. I mean, it's the terminology. So, it's like if you find a person, single person to do it. That's all what we require.
Now, we are here only participants in the room.
So one of the participants will create for the entire RC. That's it. And they will, the others will contribute to it. So the person who is editing the page, he will use multiple mechanisms to get all these details and then post it in the page.
Okay, sir. Just one more question, sir.
Yeah.
Finally, we have to paste it in Padlet, right?
Ah, so
how to submit it finally?
Let's say you have around 20 participants in your RC, remote center now. So one of the participants will start creating WordPress web page. Okay. Meanwhile, the other participants will consolidate all their queries, questions, and also their individual WordPress web pages, participant names, etc. So while the team leader is creating all the web page things, the others will contribute all the questions. This will be posted by the team leader in the WordPress web page. Because it's the team leader who has edit permission to the WordPress web page. Now, once this is done, you will share the URL of your WordPress web page in Padlet.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. I'll now go to RC 1132, Padampath Singhania University, Udaipur.
Being a remote center coordinator and workshop coordinator, I am actually doing something different. Because I my website is hosted by me and I have a 30 GB space. So what I have done, I have created some subdomain rather a space. Like just now I have created SPSU blog.spsu.ac.in.
Okay.
So and created that with a basic WordPress. I just installed WordPress there.
Yeah.
So what I've done, I have given in a pair group two created admin for a particular page under that particular subdomain, and instead of creating in a different free domain, in that subdomain they are creating some pages. Okay. Someone is, you know, posting the questions, someone is posting their comments, and finally I will post it to you so that you can view. And 2-3 persons are actually looking into other WordPress which is being posted by other different remote center coordinator.
Okay.
But I am engaging everyone in a different way.
Yeah, that's fine.
So instead of having it in an open forum.
So I understand, yes, what you've done. So you have, let's say, multiple collaborators within your local WordPress installation, right?
In our website itself.
Yeah,
yes.
That's fine. That is fine. But what happens is you need to have a consolidated view of all these questions. So let's say each participant has their own subdomains. You should have in your main page, you should provide link to these subdomains so that people who are coming in, they'll be able to go and see all the questions. So ensure that this is there. So the essential idea is we are doing a crowdsourcing for questions and a crowdsourcing for solutions. So we are just for the crowd to understand where it is, the navigation, usability, etc. has to be pretty straightforward. Otherwise, they will say that no, you didn't post any questions over there, etc., etc. So ensure that there is a consolidated list of URLs or questions other participants can individually go and check.
And also, we need to review other WordPress,
yes,
sites of posted by other different RCs, right?
Yes.
Should we review and post it in our WordPress, or is it in their WordPress?
So that's, you will not be so question. You will not be given edit permission in their WordPress website, right? So what you can do is, whatever solutions you create, first provide these answers as a comment in the Padlet, where the all of you will be able to see the questions and answers. Then individually, within your own web page, consolidate all these answers and provide them in the answers posted.
Okay, fine.
Yeah. So now I'll go to the next RC, 1294, Geetanjali Institute of Science and Technology.
Sir, I'm getting mails from IIT Bombay X. When I just install with me, when I give my Gmail ID for the WordPress, my WordPress ID is not been getting access with my account, which is given with IIT Bombay X. So if I give any ID regarding FTP 101X and my name with the WordPress, even that's not been net taking towards it. In the same when I was going with RCA1, I had the same problem.
Okay. Basically, IIT Bombay X registration and WordPress are two different entities. So you can use any email ID to create a WordPress web page.
No, I've done using two different email IDs, but the same problem I'm getting. I'm not able to do anything even in RCA1. I had the same problem.
No,
even
so,
I was not able to upload
okay,
due to
so,
the WordPress
so,
link.
Let me just understand the issue. So you are creating a WordPress web page, right?
The link is not getting access. My WordPress link, though I give enter too many multiple passwords also, it's not seeking me my password. It's giving me it's an invalid.
So you are using it in the main WordPress website, right?
Yes.
Have you tried the forgot password option for your site? So what you are saying
yes,
is
I've
that
tried it. Yeah.
So you are saying that you are not able to edit your own WordPress web page.
Yes.
Question number one, have you registered to WordPress initially?
Yes.
URL has been allotted to you, correct?
Yes.
And then you create all the pages, correct?
Yes.
So this domain that you create, so are you copying the URL when you edit, or are you giving the generic URL? So let's suppose you have created participant1.wordpress.com, okay? But when you do the edits, you may go into WP admin and do the edit. So the URL that you see on top is a different URL. Yes. So you should create, it will give you an accessible URL.
Sir, we have one more question here. Sir, actually, okay, you have given us 20 minutes time to complete this particular creation of page as well as the participant list, and then upload the participant list along with the WordPress links.
Yes.
And questions, and then again evaluation of the other RC member.
No. So the first 20 minutes is only for activities till consolidation of questions. And this is where, as an RC, you should do a distribution of activities. It's a teamwork. So while the RC coordinator or whoever is the coordinator is creating the web page, what you can do is give a shared Google Doc, two shared Google Docs to all the other participants and ask them to populate their name and link their web page over there. Similarly, the second Google Doc can be used for consolidating all the queries that they have. So, all you then need to do is each participant will work on populating these pages, and as a coordinator, all you have to do is just copy paste whatever text is written in the Google Doc into your WordPress web page. So, in that way, this entire 20 minutes, so you should not wait for the RC coordinator to complete the WordPress web page creation and do it individually. Each participant has to be engaged. Okay, so do the team division and distribution of activities like that.
Sir, when we make the questions, should every question should have a discussion or blog, something where the people can write to give the solution to that in the WordPress?
So it is good that if you have a comment box enabled for questions posted, that would be really good. Otherwise also you can, over here we are using Padlet's comment feature to consolidate all the answers. So there is
but if it is there in this website, okay, tomorrow no we can also have the view of it, no? But in Padlet again, we have to go back to Padlet.
Yeah, that is fine. So why Padlet is because in a single place, you will have all the answers. So all the questions, all the answers at a single place, rather than going and individually going into individual RC's page, you have all the questions and all the answers in a single Padlet page.
Okay, when we are creating the participant list, we can hyperlink our name with our
yes
WordPress links.
Yes, that is desirable.
Because instead of giving the name and then
so
complete link, I think this will be the best one for us.
So while giving, so I was under the assumption that everyone will understand it, but let me explicitly say, hyperlinking names with the WordPress URLs is the best way to go forward. Do not give separate text URL text.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Coming back to the first query regarding WordPress web page, is there some solution for because I'm not able to understand the query, because in WordPress web page, when you create it once, that publicly accessible URL, it should be accessible by others.
But the problem is that, okay, when she is again trying to access it, even though we are generating the forgot password and again login with that, it is not at all getting logged in. It is telling invalid password. Continuously, she has done for the first account and even the second email ID. Ma'am has created one more account. Even in that particular situation, the same type of response is coming from WordPress.
So what is the...
If anyone is making any mistake for one time, we are getting the same problem.
What you do is, after creating the page, try and see whether... open it in a new private window and see whether the main URL. So, if I create one URL, public URL is visible for everyone, right? Use that public URL and put it in the private window and see whether you can access that page.
We can see the page, but the thing is, okay, to edit the profiles, we need to log in with the password to edit all these things, am I right?
Yes.
That login credentials are not getting accepted at any cost, even though we make forgot password. And we generate a new password.
So are you sure that the username and password are you are giving the same?
Yeah, they are correct. We are getting it to the same email ID to which we have linked it.
Okay.
We are generating the password. We are again using that new password which is generated, and again we are getting the same problem there.
Okay. I mean, immediate solution, just go to WordPress, contact us and post this as a query over there and see what's the response that they're technical team is giving to you. So they will be listing out certain steps which you have to do and which will help you in identifying the exact problem. I mean, from my side, I don't see why this should happen. I mean, this should never happen. What you are trying, what you are saying, this should never happen.
Should we create the common licenses for the WordPress that we are creating for the RC?
Yeah, it is decided that you put all, see, because the questions that you post is an individual's intellectual property. But when you register for the workshop, we have said that all the activities within this workshop will be under Creative Commons and it is shared to all. So it is, yes, you should put the Creative Commons license in the questions posted as well, because each question is an intellectual property. Let me go to RC 1343, Supreme Knowledge Foundation Group, West Bengal.
when we are replying to WordPress site in Padlet, it is always showing anonymous. So how do we do it so that our name reflects?
So for that you will have to register to Padlet. So you will have to sign up for Padlet and then register in it.
Which site we have to write? Padlet?
Padlet.com. So it's like how you create a email account with Google. Similarly, you will have to create an account with Padlet. Go to padlet.com, click on sign up and provide the required registration details like email ID or other things. Then a Padlet, you can create your own Padlet account. Once you have this account, then you can use that to go and post. Then while you are logged in, go to the shared Padlet and start posting. Then your name will be visible.
Okay.
RC1223. RBS Engineering Technical Campus, Agra.
I have submitted my RCC activity. And after the submitting of the RCC activity, where we have to submit the peer review?
Okay, the pair activity, see, all you have to do is within a RC, form teams and start looking into the other web pages that have been created by other RCs. So, let's say I am seeing around 20-30 participants in your RC. So, you will have around 15 groups, 15 pairs. So, those each pair will go and look into the same Padlet post and identify other RC's URL. Go and look into the questions that they posted.
Okay, so you have to be submitted individual group for that, huh?
Yes, so the group formation has to happen within the RC. So it's a physical activity.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
We wanted to ask you.
Huh?
Groups, when we do the activity and after reviewing the RC's questions, where do we have to write the answers?
So, you can go back to the same Padlet post. There is a feature called comment. You can post your answers in that comment.
Okay. You don't have to write on the WordPress site.
No. So, you don't need to write on the WordPress site. But if you want to first write in the WordPress site, that is also fine. You can just copy paste from WordPress site and then go back and you will not be given access to their WordPress site. You can just view the site, right? So, the Padlet is a place where you have public access. So, you can go there and put it in comment. So, it's like how you reply in discussion forum. So, put it as a comment. So, all the answers will be visible for the other RCs as well.
Okay, the group and the solo activity, both things you have to do in the Padlet.
Yes, on the Padlet.
Okay. So,
let me now go to RC1269.
Sir, our course coordinator create the workspace, particular peer review. Then the link paste in Padlet.
Yes.
Then?
Then within the RC, the participants go and look into the some other links posted by other RCs. So you would have posted one. So it will come as one note. The participants now have to explore all the other RC links and find answers for their questions.
Our question and answer, where we write in the our course coordinator page?
So, the questions have to be asked, posted in the WordPress page that you created for your RC.
Our participant, all participant link are there in the our course coordinator workspace?
Yes. So, you will have four pages in the RC page.
Yes.
So, in the first one will be about RC, correct?
Yes.
The second page will be where the all the participants are listed and their WordPress pages are linked.
Okay.
In the third page, you will have to consolidate all the queries from your RC and post it in the third page.
Okay.
After doing that, you share the WordPress web page in Padlet.
Okay.
Now, while going to Padlet, you can see other RCs also posting their own URLs.
Okay.
Now, within your RC, all the participants have to pair up and take unique RCs and look into the questions posted by that RC.
Okay.
Okay. And then all the answers that they know, they will post in the Padlet.
Okay. Time is extended or not?
So, you can start the activity. So, this is a continuing activity. We will be doing a similar activity tomorrow also. So, continue doing it. Across the week, we will be monitoring the Padlet page and each individual RC's web page. So start creating the web page and start doing the activity.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Yeah, Symbiosis RC1190.
Sir, we have created the page with the four tabs that you have mentioned. Now the only query is that the answers that we have to post would be part of the same tab that we have created as answers into the website.
Okay, the answers that you give to other RCs, everything has to be consolidated and posted in that particular web page, answers posted page.
So there has to be four tabs only into the web page, right?
Yes, there has to be only four tabs in the page.
And the answers tab that we have created, answers that we have provided to the other RC should be part of that page only.
Exactly.
There is no other tab, right?
There is no other tab.
Okay, 1 second, sir. 1 second.
Yeah.
Sir, I have a doubt. When we post all the answers, it looks very illogical to me. Because those comments are like, from what question those answers are given, we are not providing. So how it will help the visitor?
How do you post the RC? It is up to you. As a RC, what you can do is, let's say RC1131 had these four questions. To this, our answers are, one, this so-and-so is the answer, two, so-and-so is the answer, three, so-and-so is the answer.
Now, that process is going to take time because we have consolidated all the answers, sir.
Yes, that
so
is
now
fine.
So now to mapping with RC and questions is going to take maybe a lot of time.
Yeah, that is fine.
So what we can do now?
So this activity, so you have started off with the activity.
Correct, sir. Correct.
Okay.
So we have done. We have created.
So you have created the web page. So that is one good thing. And you have also posted all the queries from your remote center.
Correct. Yes.
Okay. So now you can take time.
Sir.
So now you can take time across the entire week to start answering the queries.
Oh, okay.
Okay. See, the idea behind this activity is to increase collaboration between participants across RCs. It is not a time-bound activity, and it is a knowledge creation and knowledge sharing through crowdsourcing mechanisms. Okay, so the rationale is that this is a crowdsourcing mechanism activity, and we are giving infinite time for you to complete the activity.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah. Any other queries?
Thank you, everyone.
Yeah. RC1043, Sarvajanik Engineering College.
Yeah, good evening, sir. We are using this Padlet and we are trying to provide answer for various questions, but whichever remote center we are clicking, it is moving up and down and we are facing difficulty in providing comments.
Okay, so what I would recommend is, let's say, one of you fix on one RC and provide comments over there. So you have created your own RC's web page, right?
Yes.
So as individuals, now pairing up is also done at your RC, correct?
Yes.
So in the pair phase, you have the answers that are available. So what you can do is see one moment where it is not moving and try to provide answer. In the meantime, in your own web page, try consolidating all these answers. So the queries and answers, you can consolidate in your own web page itself.
Yes, parallelly we are doing that.
Okay, great. Any other queries that you have?
Answer. Yes, it is related to screencast.
Okay.
Using Screencast-O-Matic, whichever video we are creating, we are trying to create in silent room only, but still there is some noise. So is there any way for that noise removal?
So there is a audio driver settings. You can try, go to control panel of your laptop or desktop and see the audio driver settings. So over there, you can adjust noise levels and see what is the quality of the output.
Okay, so we'll try that.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Some of the general queries that are coming is how to post in Padlet. All you have to do is just go into the Padlet website and click on it. I'm just sharing the Padlet website once again. How can we see others' Padlet site? So others' Padlet site, so they are creating their own URL, WordPress URLs. So all you have to do is they will be posting that URL in Padlet. You can just go and click. So the question from GH Raisoni is, should you go ahead and answer the queries raised by other RCs? Yes. Go and visit the web pages that has been posted by other RCs in the Padlet, take up those queries as pairs. As pairs, take 3 RCs together first, then together try to solve 1 RC's queries in the pair phase, and in the solo phase you can take the other 2 individually and answer the queries. Is it clear, ma'am? You can raise your hand if you can show like this if the explanation is clear, else you can do this. Okay, so I see a thumbs up from one of the participant over there. See, the rationale of this activity is that all of you will be involved, all of you will be generating new questions, new solutions, and all of this is available at a single place. Now, something like a OER repository that Professor Fatak briefly hinted today morning is an idea like this, where everybody can come together, collaborate, and the knowledge is shared among all the participants. So all the web page URLs that you have in Padlet are essentially open education resources. So over here, each web page will have lot of these questions that you have about AVIEW, Moodle, CamStudio or Screencast-O-Matic and WordPress. So all these queries will be available over there, and the answers that you have given to other RCs, that is also available. So this open education resource is what we want to promote, and this is a collaborative activity to do that. Supposing that the time today has ended, do not worry, this activity is extended across the FDP. So you can continue posting the queries, others can go and visit RCs and try to look at different questions that have come up. At the end, we will also look at the RCs that are contributing maximum into the knowledge pool. So finally, we will go to this Padlet website and look at each individual RC's web page, and then we will be taking stock of how much each RC has contributed, and this will have impact on the RC rating by the workshop team. We will have some incentive mechanisms for RCs where their rating gets improved if they collaborate more and if they provide answers to queries raised by other participants. RC1155.
When we are posting our answer in Padlet, it is showing as anonymous. What it means that? And how we come to know that whether individual participant has posted their answers?
Okay, so this is a general query from, so let me repeat the question. In the Padlet, when people are posting, currently they see something like anonymous written on top of the comments. This is happening because you are not registered in the Padlet website. Okay, Padlet, like any other software service, requires a registration, a sign up process. This is a public link where we are just putting it up so that anyone can come over, see and post. So to ensure that your name is seen in the comment, all you have to do is go to padlet.com and sign up. It's like how you sign up for an email ID or any other new software service. So once you sign up, and within your login, if you go and visit the page, then whenever you type the comment, your name will be visible.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. So with this, we have come to the end of interaction on day 1. Today, let me just summarize what has happened from today morning. So from today morning, we have been looking at engaging you in multiple activities. So in the morning, as Professor Fatak and Professor Sridhar said, the focus of this particular FDP is on utilizing effective activities. So specifically active learning strategies within the classroom so that technology integration is meaningful both for the teacher as well as the learner, and more importantly for the learner. In the second session, Dr. Sameer Sahasrabuddhe provided you a walkthrough of how to do peer review in IIT Bombay X. And in case of queries or grievances regarding peer review, the process is that you consolidate all the query and give it to your mentor, who will consolidate all these queries from different mentees and provide to IIT Bombay. We will definitely be looking at penalty points for poor peer review. In the third session, Professor Sahana Murthy provided you more insights about active learning as a mechanism to move from 20th century teaching to 21st century teaching. So, in this particular session, a very specific strategy called peer instruction and think, pair, share were discussed. You actually did lot of one or two peer instruction and think, pair, share strategies, and some of the queries regarding active learning were sorted out in that particular session. In this final session, what we have done is we have tried to utilize the collaborative tool Padlet to ensure that all the remote centers become actively engaged in solving one another's query. So, we have used the mechanism of crowdsourcing, where we have asked everyone to post out their queries, and when these queries are posted, then based on that, each RCs will have a team. They will create a WordPress web page, then as pairs they will go and visit other RCs WordPress web pages and look at the questions, then try to provide solution to those questions. So, this is done as a team, pair and solo. So, this is also another active learning activity that we have shown you how to do it. This is also a kind of collaborative problem solving activity. So, we will meet tomorrow, where the sessions will be more towards effective utilization of tools like visualizations, like videos and simulations, and Moodle, how to use Moodle effectively within your own teaching learning process. So, that's all from IIT Bombay for the day. Thank you.